In this video, we're computing an indefinite integral that's going to require a trig substitution. But to get set up for the trig substitution, we have to complete the square. And the whole point of completing the square is to take care of all these variable pieces with a squared binomial. So the binomial that we square to get x squared plus 4x, plus possibly some constants, is x plus 2. When we square that, we get x squared plus 4x, that's the sum of the two cross terms there, plus 4. So to get back to the same value we started with, there was a plus 5 there, we have to have a plus 1 left over, and the square is completed. Next, I want to be able to express all this stuff as a single squared trig function, and I have a variable thing squared plus 1. So what I need to do is get a tangent squared plus 1, and I'll be able to replace that with secant squared. So I'm going to make a trig substitution. Let's x plus 2 equal tangent theta. That means dx is going to be secant squared theta d theta. And at the end of this integral, I'm going to have to transform back in terms of x. And just to get ready to do that, I'll go ahead and write down what theta is. That's the angle whose tangent is x plus 2, and I'll have to sub that in at the end of the problem. So let's go ahead and transform the integral now. Dx was secant squared theta d theta. So I'm going to put the secant squared theta in the numerator here. I'll just put the d theta out there on the end. Then in my square root, I have all this stuff that I got from completing the square inside of that square root. And that's x plus 2 quantity squared, which is tangent squared theta plus 1. Now we use the Pythagorean identity for secant and tangent. And tangent squared theta plus 1 is secant squared theta. So that denominator gives us just a secant theta. And one factor of secant is going to cancel. And I end up with the integral of secant theta d theta. Now this antiderivative is just a standard formula you should have memorized. And I get the natural log of the absolute value of secant theta plus tangent theta plus an arbitrary constant c. Now if I go back and plug in the definition of theta, I have the natural log of the absolute value of the secant of the inverse tangent, or the angle whose tangent is x plus 2, plus the tangent of the angle whose tangent is x plus 2. Now the tangent of the angle whose tangent is x plus 2 is x plus 2, so that's done. But the secant of the angle whose tangent is x plus 2, that requires a little geometric construction. It's also possible to do it using trig identities, but my preference has always been this little geometric construction. So I draw a right triangle and I label the angle theta there. That's the angle whose tangent is x plus 2, which means I could write x plus 2 for the opposite side and 1 for the adjacent side. And then I need to find out how big the hypotenuse is. Well, the hypotenuse is the square root of the sum of the squares of the two legs. And then I recognize that x plus 2 quantity squared plus 1 is the same thing I had in the interior of my original square root. That's just its completed square form. So now I should be able to write down the secant of this angle. And that's just 1 over the cosine, which is hypotenuse over adjacent. So it's just going to be that square root piece. And I'm going to go ahead and write the interior of that square root in its expanded form. It's just the original interior that we started the whole integral with. And then I have a x plus 2 as my second term. Finish my absolute value bar, and don't forget the plus c. And we're done. If you find the math content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce dozens of new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.